Greetings, good evening. This is my second YouTube video, and tonight I'm wanting to talk a little bit about a study I recently read. As I mentioned in my other video and blogs, I had quit my AIDS drugs about 6 years ago, so I find reports like this of great interest. The study is called LOTTI, and that's L-O-T-T-I, stands for Long-Term Treatment Interruption. And the study recently reported that those of us who have had success with treatment interruption or vacations might not be all that unusual. There were two groups in this study, which was done in Italy. They were all patients taking HAART, highly active retroviral therapy, or the AIDS cocktails. And one group took the drugs continuously. That was one arm. The second arm took vacations or interrupted their therapy based on CD4 counts. The counts used in this study were 700. At 700 CD4 count, patients on the STI arm could quit their drugs until their CD4 count dropped to 350 or lower, at which time they would restart their drug treatment. What was really cool about this study is that over a fourth of the patients in the STI arm, when they quit their drugs, they never had to restart. Which has been my strategy since I quit the drugs 6 years ago, though I would use a little bit different numbers for the CD4 counts, perhaps. The study really offers hope to people who are either taking or facing a choice of taking antiretroviral drugs because of their concern for long-term effects, or perhaps they're experiencing illness because of the toxicities. There really are no good reasons for HAART patients to stay on the drugs continuously and indefinitely, and there are several advantages to stopping them. There's reduced toxicity. There were more cardiological problems due to the effects of drug toxicity in the continuous arm than there were in the STI arms. And these problems are well known, but modern clinical practice is to simply prescribe even more drugs to deal with the effects. The other known effects of continuous HAART drug use includes disfiguring body effects like lipodystrophy, liver disease, bone problems, and aberrant blood levels with lipids, enzymes, and hormones. The big boogeyman most frequently used to try to discourage patients from interrupting their HAART treatment is drug resistance. And the LOTTI study found that drug resistance was actually higher in the continuous group than it was in the STI group. In other words, being off the drugs didn't cause resistance, but being on them did. There was only one patient in the STI arm who developed resistance, and that was while they were taking the drug, supposedly after achieving viral suppression. So this really contradicts the common wisdom that's usually heard in the doctor's offices. CD4 counts. While about the same number of patients in each arm reached one of the so-called primary endpoints, which in this study was defined as death or disease, those in the continuous arm had a mean CD4 count of 891, almost 900, compared to 557 in the STI arm. So having a higher level of CD4 counts in this study, at any rate, did not result in lowering either death or disease. So much for the protective power of higher CD4 counts. The daily drug costs, treatment costs for patients on the STI arm was less than half of that of the continuous drug group. Now, cost alone should never be the determining factor in treatment choices, but there never seems to be enough money to fuel the AIDS machine, so this is an important finding too. The other study that's pretty widely quoted when drug vacations or structured treatment interruptions are mentioned is the SMART study, which was funded by the U.S. National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases. This was an international study with over 5,400 patients in 33 countries. The study was terminated early because supposedly of too many deaths and adverse effects. What's really strange about this study is that 79 of those 85 deaths occurred in the U.S., even though only 55% of the patients in the study were from the U.S. These and other weird aberrations about this study are mentioned in a link that is in my report on the LOTTI study on my blog, which I hope you'll go and actually look at the study itself, and I write a little bit more about LOTTI and raise questions about why isn't this information being more widely publicized. You won't find any promotion of the information from LOTTI on the pharmaceutical-funded AIDS sites like AIDS.com or AIDSmeds.com, PAWS.com, TheBody.com, which is just inexcusable to me. I know of friends and other people who are on HAART, and I support their choices and their decision to take those drugs. My point is that decisions, we need information to make informed decisions. And this is important information that every person who is facing this choice should have. I know people who are having problems with the drugs but are scared to death, basically, to quit them. And we need more of this type of encouragement, that there's really not there's not as much to lose to give it a try. Now, if it doesn't work, you can go back on the drugs. If it does, you might never have to go back on them. That's my hope, at any rate. Go check out the blog. It's resistanceisfruitful.wordpress.com, or there's a link to it on the YouTube page here. And read the study, read my report, feel free to comment. Thanks.